Right, well, this is Let's Ski About That. And as you can see, we're not at the ranch today. That'll come and go, but it's pretty hot around here, Minnesota today. And I'm gonna record where it's a little cooler. That's what I'm gonna do. So this last week, we got out and did some roller skiing, and I checked in with Iceman. He got some done as well. My camera crew has been suspect yet again, so I will chop up a little bit, put it over here, and it's a little rocky because my sidekick Charles was helping me out, but it's all right. It was still fun to get out and try it out. I found a little steeper hill, didn't crash this time, and that's pretty great. So anyway, yeah, I'll put that in here. And then another fun thing happened is I ordered some inexpensive 3-pin binders to convert some old classic cross classic style cross country skis into classic style cross country skis. Anyway, we're gonna throw those 3 pins on there, and I'll have footage of that happening in the next video. And we'll see what goes. I was recently talking to a guy a coworker who said that he got into it on account of some projects that we had done in the past, and he thought it was a good time. So we're gonna give it a shot, and if I'm not mistaken, Iceman also has some, so maybe we can get some footage of us all goofing off this when the snow flies again. What else is going on around here? I don't have a lot of stuff today. So anyway, I did get some low altitude training in, and I haven't really expanded on that, but I do wear that shirt that says low altitude training team. So what that is I went to Corn Harvest maybe a decade ago with some buddies of mine, and we had this joke that we were the low altitude training team because we just drove straight through the night to Loveland, Colorado from Minneapolis, and then we tried our darndest to ski hard all day and got a hotel till maybe like 4 in the morning, and we got and hit it right back. So we were just gone for like not even a long weekend because we left Friday after work. I went to Corn Harvest, had a good time, but it was a hard push. Anyway, so that's where low altitude training team comes from. And so, in an effort to make quality use of something as fun as the low altitude training team, I've got a little extra right here. Oh, no, why? It's backwards. It's backwards. Anyway, I was at Blue Mountain State Park with the fam doing some camping, and I found a trail that had some excellent stairs. So as you watch me run up it, just understand that I'm not, in the best shape, and I wasn't really prepared to find the stairs or this trail that lent itself so well to me beating myself up for a second. So anyway, got some low altitude training. I've been doing a lot of walking as well, trying to cut a little weight before the big ski season here coming up. We'll see if we can't have a little bit easier go this year. I don't know. Must be getting old. I just felt like last year, I just felt like I wasn't having as good a season as I should have. So we're trying out some general walking. Can't go to the club, extra fitness club because of COVID right now. So anybody else able to get into the club and exercise? I don't know. So let me know. What kind of exercises are you guys doing? Does anybody do for get ready for the ski season? Yeah, anyway, let me know, and I think we're gonna throw together some like 30-day challenges to put out and see if we can get some participation. So that'll be pretty cool. I don't have much else this week either. I had planned to get more roller skiing done to be able to show and talk about, and I just didn't materialize the way I had hoped, mostly because every surface treats you differently, as you might imagine. And I haven't found the perfect surface. Let me hear about what you do for training in the summertime. Dry land training, low altitude training, 12-ounce curls training. I don't know. Let me hear about it. Oh no, I did want to talk about one more thing. I did not find, we stumbled upon Tyrolia Basin over near Blue Mound State Park in Wisconsin. And it's a small resort in Wisconsin, but they had a magic carpet, a couple chairlifts, some rope tows. They have an action archery section for the summer where I don't know if you've never done this. It's you hike and shoot and targets placed throughout the place. And then also they had frisbee golf, which I didn't know if those two things went hand in hand, you know, guys playing frisbee golf and archers. I don't know. So it was interesting and not much, but we did go check it out. We did a little dry land training. We ran up one hill and walked down the other. All right, let's check on the lift tickets quick. Adult all day lift ticket, $48 for the weekend. Weekday, $17 if you buy it before 4 p.m. That's not too bad. What do you guys think is too much money for a day ticket at a place where you don't ski all the time? I'm at like $60 or less is kind of where I'm at. I don't know. Is that crazy? Is that too high? I don't know. What do you guys think? Friday nights are $18. Oh, they're open till 11 p.m. That's amazing. I gotta get over there and check this place out in the wintertime. So what other kind of tiny resorts are people go to? I don't know. Let me know. Let's see. Looks like, oh man, disc golf. Oh, they even have last mow date. Is that a big thing to disc golfers? I suppose you don't want to be walking through knee-high grass, right? Trying to find a disc. Trail map. What do we got? We have that amounts to, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 25. We'll call it 25 runs, based on this trail map here. Pretty good. I can dig it. Let's see, do they mention what you charge for a lesson? Let's have a look.